Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of GUI's Dungeon Dive, the podcast where I, GUI, rank all of the dungeons in The Legend of Zelda, and this week in Oracle of Ages, after completing Jabu Jabu's belly, we are gifted the Zora Scale. This gives us access to the Sea of Storms, where we will reunite with the Pyrations we once met in Oracle of Seasons. We aid them by giving them the Zora Scale, allowing them to escape the Sea of Storms, and in return, we are given the Tokay Eyeball, which opens up a secret passageway on Crescent Island. After testing our power, wisdom, and courage, the path leads to a giant maze within the Sea of No Return. Navigating this passageway leads us to the dungeon of our final essence of time, Ancient Tomb. And there's something I love about how this dungeon seems to be magically hidden from the Maku Tree, and also how hidden and protected the route is. That sort of feeling kind of carries over into the dungeon as well, as when you first enter it, it appears to be only two rooms, and only after getting a hint from the owl statue there, we can discover a secret, bombable wall that's hidden behind a statue. That eventually leads to another hidden passageway that takes you further underground. What lies beneath are two massive floors that only grow larger as you go down. It seems like maybe it's an underground pyramid or something like that, looking at the map. As I said though, it's massive. It's sort of acting as a final dungeon here, so that's fitting. Not only does it fit the bill in that regard, but it also does a great job of incorporating like every item, puzzle, dungeon element from all the previous dungeons. Everything is on display here. Each floor of the dungeon also acts as its own section or challenge on its own as well, with some slight traversal between the two floors. After accessing the first basement floor, the first floor-spanning navigational puzzle we come upon combines the use of two of those roundabout platforms, as well as the crystal floor switches, and they throw in some switch hook spots, small keys, locks, and the dungeon item, which is the power glove, and it creates for a great fun navigational puzzle that, you know, really takes up this whole giant floor. It's a great final test of a lot of these elements too, from the various dungeons in the game. But after this, we move on to the most expansive floor of the whole dungeon. First, we have to do battle with this blue Stalfos that looks kind of like death. It's another fight reminiscent of Aghanim, and it's pretty fun, but we're led here to yet another hidden passageway that we must open. This requires exploration of the entire floor, and it's a mostly non-linear hunt to pick up these four stone tablets and the boss key. These tablets are found in the four corners of the floor, one in a maze filled with the blade traps that chase you, one's in a flowing waterway where you have to avoid the pits, one's in a more icy area and we ride some minecarts there, and one is protected by a lava flow. These can be picked up in pretty much any order, and when they get placed around this large stone tablet, it opens up and creates a path to the lair of the final boss, Ramrock. Now, Ramrock looks like a relative of Bongo Bongo, only he's made of stone. It's a pretty involved boss fight. It has many different challenging phases. In the first phase, he shoots his disembodied fists out, and you gotta hit him back at him to do damage to him. Then after that, he comes and tries to smash you, and the trick here is to get it so that he smashes a bomb instead of Link, which blows up right in his face. In the third phase, he gains these protective shields around him, and the trick is to ricochet with a seed shooter, a seed off the wall and hit him in the back. And then finally, in his last phase, he gets these giant cannonball arms that shoot out, and if you grab the one that's just sitting there and pull it back and fling it back at him, that will do damage to him that will eventually lead to his demise. And it's both fun and challenging. I think it's a great fight. And that, of course, brings us to our final essence of time, the Falling Star. The eternal light of this heavenly body acts as a guide to the other essences. And so now we're ready to take on, you know, the final portion of this game. But first, we gotta rank this dungeon. I think it's easy when just looking at the dungeons we have here in the game. I think this does a great job of being sort of the acting final dungeon. We got one more episode left with Corey to kind of wrap up the end of the game. But this is sort of like the final test, the Ganon's Tower, the Turtle Rock, has a similar job of Turtle Rock and Sword and Shield Maze of kind of being the last big full dungeon while still kind of being its own thing. And I think this does a great job, like Ganon's Tower, of mixing in all the elements, but not unlike Ganon's Castle in Ocarina of Time, kind of separating them into their own little areas. There is a little bit of that, though. But I think this is awesome. There's a lot thematically going for it that I want to put it at the top of the list of Oracle of Ages dungeons. So because it incorporates all those elements in their own way, it's a great final test of a lot of these things. Some aren't as, like the mine carts are just kind of there to be there, but I do like that floor spanning room with the two roundabouts and the crystal switches. It makes awesome navigation. Sort of the element of like the thematic element of like the hidden passageways and how hidden this is works really well. It's got a lot of, you know, creatures like that that fit the bill too, like a lot of Gyarados and stuff like that I should have mentioned. It's the top of the charts here for Oracle of Ages. The question is it better than Ganon's Tower, which does a similar thing I was talking about of mentioning or of bringing in all those elements? And it's a close one. I think it still does have, like, it has the one part, the non-linear part of collecting the tablets that are in their different areas, and there's kind of elements that are, you know, separate there, kind of like Ganon's Castle from Ocarina. But I think the overall, like, challenge and, like, use of these elements is pretty fun, and it still does, like, mix them together still. I'm kind of torn. It does have, like, its own separate sections in a way, like, Ganon's Tower, you kind of do, like, the basement first and then work your way up. It's a real tough one, I think. Does it go top five? You know what? I think, I'm willing to say it can. I think it can. I think I am willing to say, yeah, I think it does a really good job. And I just overall like the big sprawling layout. It's kind of very, Death Mountain-y actually. From the original Zelda. It's very close, though, so I might change my mind later, but I think this can bust the top five. I think it is an awesome, really fun dungeon. I think I'm gonna keep it there. But one thing I just noticed that this does, and I don't like it, it doesn't sit well with me, is it bumps the Forest Temple out of the top 10, and I think some people are already disagree with my placement as it is, think it's too low, but it certainly needs to be in the top 10 for right now. So I'm willing to put it above Turtle Rock, because yeah, it's got to be in there. If we're kind of in these classic Zelda dungeons, Forest Temple gotta be top 10, and I'm pretty satisfied with that feeling right now overall. Yeah, that's looking pretty good to me. Let me know if you agree. Oracle of Ages, it's done a fine job, I think. It's been a great game slotting in here with some of the greats. But we gotta wrap it up. We're gonna do one more episode that's kind of like the post-game, similar to how we did with Seasons, even though it didn't really have a final dungeon, and that should be really fun. We're gonna see what Corey thought about the game. You know, we'll talk more in depth. You know, be a long, nice long episode, and and then we'll get ready for the next game next season. So Thanks for following along with these Oracle games. I was wondering how it was gonna go, and I think it's been a great two seasons. So, yeah, with that, I'll see you next week.